students, let's continue with our classical TCP improvements. In the previous video, I explained about the indirect TCP. Now coming to the next classical TCP improvement, which is going to improve the TCP performance in the case of wireless and the mobile environment. That is a snooping TCP. Snooping. Here the transparent extension of TCP within the foreign agent. So in the snooping, we are using one concept, that is a transparent extension of TCP within the foreign agent. So everything whatever that you use in the indirect is the same, but the only thing in the snooping is here the transparent extension of TCP within the foreign agent is establishing. Let's see what is it. The buffering of a packet sent to the mobile host. So the foreign agent is holding, that is the intruder is holding the buffering of packets, it holds the buffer. So that buffering of packets is sending to the mobile host one by one. Suppose if lost packet on the wireless link, so there is a chances in the losting of packets in the wireless communication. So suppose, let us think, lost packet on the wireless link, that is in the both directions, will be retransmitted immediately by the mobile host or foreign agent respectively. So called local retransmission is there in the foreign agent as well as the mobile host. So we here the foreign agent is there, and here the fixed network is there, fixed host is there, and here the mobile host is there. So here a TCP, mobile TCP connection is established in these two areas, and this is a standard TCP. So here a buffer is stored in the foreign agent, which is a router. Router holds the buffer. So packets are forwarding to the mobile host, as well as the mobile host is transferring the packets to the foreign agent. Suppose in that case, either in the mobile host or in the foreign agent, the packet may be lost. So what it will do? It will retransmit immediately either the foreign agent or the mobile host. So that you call it as a local retransmission. So this everything is present local because it is completely present in one network. This foreign agent and the mobile host is present in one network. So this is a local retransmission. The foreign agent therefore snoops the packet flow and recognizes the acknowledgements in both the directions. It also filters acknowledgement. Okay, so now here the changes of TCP, whatever the changes that we occurred in the TCP only within the foreign agent. The thing you have to remember that the snooping, whatever you're doing there, we are establishing a transparent extensions within the foreign agent. So the changes, whatever you are going to done in the TCP, that should be within the foreign agent only. So the snooping TCP as a transparent TCP extension. So see this example here. This is the correspondent host. Okay, CN, this is a correspondent host, and the wired internet is connected to the foreign agent. So don't forget this about. And coming to here, the mobile host and the foreign agent. So how the snooping of acknowledgements is established here. So here in the foreign agents, buffering of data will be there. A connection is established between the mobile host and the correspondent host. A end-to-end TCP connection is there. So buffering of data will be stored in this foreign agent. And the snooping of acknowledgement. The snooping of acknowledgement is it's a very transparent. So whenever the packet is lost, this is going to be retransmit the packet, and the foreign agent is again retransmitting the packets. The snooping of acknowledgements will be established between the mobile host as well as the foreign agent. Okay. So this is a snooping of acknowledgements in the both the directions. So this is a local retransmission. So whatever the connections that will be. Operations that is running in between the mobile host and the foreign agent, you call it as a local retransmission. And let's see the data transfer to the mobile host and data transfer from the mobile host. So to the mobile host this direction and from the mobile host this direction. How the data is transferring from foreign agent to the mobile host and from mobile host to the foreign agent in the case of snooping. Let's see. The foreign agent buffers data until it receives the acknowledgement of the mobile node. So this is a mobile node and this is a foreign agent. The foreign agent is going to buffer the data until it receives the acknowledgement of the mobile node. So until it receives the acknowledgement from the mobile node, it is going to buffer the data. So whenever it receives the acknowledgement, then it transfers one data from the buffer to the mobile node. So here the foreign agent detects a packet loss via duplicate acknowledgements or timeout. So there is a chance of foreign agent is receiving the duplicate acknowledgement, means once it's already sent the data one, suppose the packet one is sent, okay, it receives the acknowledgement two. So suppose it receives acknowledgement 2, the foreign agent is detects the packet loss via duplicate acknowledgements. So simply it is sending the acknowledgement 2 like that. Suppose it is a packet 3 is sent, acknowledgement 2 is received. After receiving the 2, it sends a packet 3. Okay, again it sends acknowledgement 2 only. Okay, then the foreign agent sends the packet 4. Again it sends the acknowledgement 2 only. So by seeing this, the foreign agent detects a packet loss is occurred. How transparently? How it is possible? Because the duplicate acknowledgements or timeout cases, maybe it will be found. So duplicate acknowledgements, the same acknowledgement is sending by the mobile node. That is a duplicate acknowledgement. That with the seeing this duplicate acknowledgements, the foreign agent detects there is a packet loss. Fast retransmission possible, transparent for the fixed network. So there is a chance fast retransmissions is possible and the transparent for the fixed networks. Data transfer from mobile host. So from mobile host, how the data is transferred. Suppose the foreign agent detects a packet loss on the wireless link via sequence number. So these are the sequence numbers. The foreign agent answers directly with a negative acknowledgement to the mobile node. So whenever it receiving the duplicate acknowledgement, the foreign agent is sending the information as a negative acknowledgement 2. So I'm receiving a negative acknowledgement 2, means the duplicate copies of acknowledgement 2 is getting. So it sends the negative acknowledgement to the mobile node. Now what the mobile node will do? The mobile node now retransmit the data only a very short delay. So within a short delay, the mobile node retransmits the data. So this is about the data transfer to the mobile host and from the mobile host. And another thing is integration of the MAC layer. So here MAC layer will be established. How this MAC layer is integrated between the mobile node and the foreign agent. The MAC layer often has similar mechanisms to those of TCP. Thus the MAC layer can already detect the duplicated packets due to retransmission and discard them. So here, what is the role of the MAC layer? The MAC layer, it detects the duplicate packets which are coming from the mobile host or to the mobile host due to retransmissions of the same sequence number, and it going to discard them packets. That work can be done by the MAC layer. Now let's see what are the problems that are facing in the snooping. The snooping TCP does not isolate the wireless link as same as the indirect TCP. And here the snooping might be useless depending on encryption schemes. So in the case of encryption schemes, the snooping might be useless. Thank you.